All right, in this video, I'm going to show you how to convert a JSON file to an Excel, CSV, or Google Sheets. So in this example, I have this JSON data. So right now I'm viewing that through Firefox, and Firefox has a built-in actually JSON parser. If I just go to this tab, see, it will make it a lot easier to read. And basically we have this data that has all this, what we can say as rows in this data, this array. See, and each line has these columns in it. And here there's also the second level for this location that has these two columns inside of that location. I was trying to find a file that has multiple levels of indentation, but I couldn't find any publicly available data sets that I could use. So I'll just go over this example with a single level, and hopefully you'll be able to take that and take it to the next level if you need to do this at all. So to be able to do this, all you need is a Google account. So a Gmail account or really any Google account. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to take that file that's going to be a file saved in my system. And I'm going to go to this colab.research.google.com. So once you're logged in with your Google account, simply go to colab.research.google.com. And that should basically bring you to this screen. So now what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to click on this new notebook, and that should get us started. So you want to probably name this notebook if you're going to be using this later on. Otherwise, it doesn't really matter. And what I'm going to do here, I'm going to get started by first uploading my file here. So what I'll do, I'll click on this little folder icon on the left, and see, it's still apparently connecting. So once it's connected, it's not going to do that anymore. But now we're done. Here, I'm just going to right click in this empty white space and click upload. And that should basically just prompt you to select one of the files. So once you get there, just select your JSON file basically and open it. And that should upload. So this is just warning you that once this runtime is over, this file is going to be deleted. So basically what that means is that once we run whatever we're going to run to do the conversion, next time you reopen this Google Colab project, this file is no longer going to be here. So if you need to do this again, you have to re-upload that file. But for now, that is sitting here. So I'll just go in here and I'm going to just do import pandas as PD. So I'll just run this line and add another code block. So now that pandas is imported as this PD, we'll do PD dot, and then we should be able to do this read JSON method. And here, all we have to do is just in quotations, pass the name of this file. So I'll just type inspections.json. That's the file name coming from here. As simple as that. So we're going to save that in a data frame. So I'll just do df equals to this. And if I run this, that should hopefully read that file. If I open another line here and just check what's inside of that df, you'll see that it basically read, let me just zoom out a little bit, that file. And see, these are those column names. So if I go back and look at that file, see, we have inspection ID, DBA name, etc. And those same things are going to be here now in more like a spreadsheet looking format. So at this point, if you don't have to deal with like a second level indentation or anything like that, you're pretty much ready to put this to an Excel file or a CSV file. So all you have to do, just do df dot and then do two. Well, let's start with Excel, I guess. That's going to be really quick. And do two Excel. I'm going to zoom in so you can see what I'm typing, and just provide the name of your Excel file you want as a result. So I'll just call this results.xlsx. So that's going to be my Excel file. So that's all I'm going to do. I'm going to run this. And that should now be here, but this is probably not refreshing. So I'm just going to click on this refresh icon right here and see this results XLSX is showing up here. So if I just go ahead and click in this and download that file, let's just go ahead and open that. So I'm going to just zoom in so you can see what's going on. So you can see we got ourselves an Excel file with that JSON data converted to a nice spreadsheet. I'm just going to close this. So just three lines and we're done, as you can see. Now, if you wanted this to be a CSV file, I would do .to CSV. Where is it? There it is. And then just name the file, right? Whatever that file name is, .csv. So if I run this, let's refresh. Now that should create, see this CSV file. So if I download this and open that file, so as you can see, my system opened that in Excel, but it really doesn't matter. So the same thing. Now we have our CSV file. So at this point, if you're a Google Sheets user, you could just open any one of these files and import that in Google Sheets. So I should be able to just go to a spreadsheet, go to file and import. And I'm just gonna basically drag that file over here. I'm just gonna use the Excel file that I've created a second ago. And we'll just insert a new sheet, I guess. And there we go. We have our data in here. So this should cover how to basically take that data and put it in here. So I want to talk about how do we do this inner level things. Now, right now in this data, we don't really have to do that because we already have these two columns. But let's say you didn't have these two columns available like this data has. So if I go back to that JSON, see they do have these two columns here, but they also have this location that repeats those two columns. Now let's assume these two weren't available by default and you had to get these two as separate columns from this location. Now by default, the way that would show up would be like this. See, in this weird JSON notation in this column instead of having two columns side by side. So to do something like that, I'm gonna go back and what I'll do, I'll just comment this line. So right now, this data frame we have here, just to refresh your memory, it's just that data, right? So it has this location column that has this thing happening in here that we want to convert to two extra columns. So what I'm gonna do on this data frame, there is a method called apply. And what it allows you to do is apply a function over each row of your data frame. Now, I guess it's not actually correct to say over each row. If you apply it the right way, it will be over each row. And what that means is that the first argument in this is gonna be the function you want to apply. So let's just call that function addColumns. So that function doesn't exist. We're gonna create it in a second. So I'm gonna do a comma, and to make sure that it applies that function over each row of our data, we're gonna have to use this parameter axis equals one to make sure that this function addColumns is applied over each row of this data df. Now this function addColumns doesn't exist, so we need to create it. So I'm gonna add a space here and do a function and the way we define it by this def, and then we do addColumns, that same function name. And that function is going to accept this parameter right here. And that parameter, I'm gonna call it R, is gonna be each row of this data set. So every time is gonna be one of these rows, and we wanna take that row and do something with it and then put it back. So what we're gonna do with that row, we're gonna go in here and hit tab to go indent this, otherwise Python is gonna give us errors in this. So to be able to get to this now location column inside of that row, we can do that by doing R and do this brackets and in quotes, provide that column name, which is called location. So I'm just gonna do that. So I'll just save this in a variable. I'll just call it LOC col or LOC column. Well, you know what? Let's just do the whole thing. I'll just call it location column. So that's basically going to be this whole column here with this JSON in it. So at this point, what I want to do, I want to take whatever's inside of this column, this object we have with this parameters, with this inner, see, like this one and the second one. So far I got to this location, which now has this other object with two things inside of it. So now inside of that, I want to get to this and this, basically, these two values. And to do that, I'm going to go back to this, and basically we're going to create a couple of other columns inside of that row. So to create a column, we just take that R and in quotes provide a new column name. So you want to provide a column name that doesn't already exist. So I'm going to just call this one LAT for the first column, and see, we have this longer name version already. I'm just basically creating a shorter version name for this extra columns that I'm going to do. And to get to that value from here, from inside of this location, I'm just going to take that location column, and inside of this, I'm going to go and say, get this part. So that should now go get from this object that we've created, the part that we need, and store it inside of this new column that we've just defined inside of our row right here. So I need to repeat this same thing for the second part. So this one we're going to call long, I guess, and we'll take the name from here. You can copy it from here, or you can copy it from, see here, it's the same thing, basically everything up to that colon. And that should now create those two columns. So now all we have to do in this function, just return that whole row, which is that R variable, after we make all these changes. So basically what this is gonna do, it's gonna take the row initially, how it was, then we're gonna add two columns to that row, and then return the row back. And we're gonna do it over and over and over and over for every single row from this data. So let's try to run this and see if this works. So I'm gonna run this. That will create the function. Then I'm gonna go back and rerun this, or run this the first time. Apparently I got an error, so I have to take a look and see what the error says. So it says float object is not. The error I get is, see on this line where we're trying to get this value from here, and apparently it's trying to get that value what it thinks is from a float instead of being like an object. All right, so let's try to do something here really quickly. I want to be able to just see if this thing fails completely or what's going on. So let's just try to, for example, just print like this and see if that ever happens. So I'm going to run this function and rerun this. Okay, so that does print something. So this means it doesn't actually give us the error on every single row, but it happens apparently on some point. So what I'm going to do to try to rectify this problem, we'll just do an if statement in this function. So what we'll do here, we'll just say if the type of that location column equals to a dictionary, which is a dict basically, then we're going to know that we should be able to do this. So we'll do a tab to indent these two lines to get inside of this if statement. So if it's not, however, so we'll do else. So in those cases, I guess we'll just leave the values blank. So I'll just copy and paste this. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to replace this with double quotes, or maybe we'll just do none. We could have done also double quotes to do a blank string. That should be fine too. So I'm just going to do this and try to see if this will fix the problem. So in this case, basically, we'll first, after we get that column for location, then we'll check, is that actually an object by doing this type check? And if it is, then we'll go and get the parts we need. Otherwise, we'll just say there's nothing in there. So I'm going to run this and rerun this function right here. Oh, no errors this time. That's good news. I want to go check those columns on the right to see if they exist. See, we created this two extra columns. Now, again, that was not necessary because we kind of already have them. Apparently, they are reversed. Did I do this right? Interesting. Let's go take a look in the data because this seems to be the opposite of what they have here, even though the values are the same. So is it the same way here? See, this is 41 for this. And then here it's negative. Yeah, so it's reversed here too. For some reason, I don't know what the reason is, but I don't really care. That's not what this is about. So I'm gonna get back. So we were able to place those in their own respective columns now inside of this. Now you wanna remember though that you need to save this back to either the same data frame or a new data frame. So I'll just call it NDF for a new data frame and rerun this. And what this is gonna do, it's gonna basically create this whole new data frame now with this new name. So if I look inside of that, that should have those extra columns that I just created here on the right. So at this point, I can just save this to, again, an Excel file or a CSV file. So I'll just do 2 Excel or 2 CSV, the same thing, and just name the file. So I'll just call this newfile.xlsx, run this line. No errors. So at this point, if I go back to this, apparently I called it new file, so let's download that and open that in Excel. And again, you could take that and import it to Google Sheets, or you could create a CSV file. But now if I just go in to show you what happened in this file, see, I have 2 extra columns here that I've created again using this data from here, and basically we have that data in here in these columns now in their own respective columns. So that's how you can go to an inner level if you have to from that JSON object like this and get the data, put it in an extra column and basically just export it again. And that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and I'll see you in the next one.